Om Shanno Mitrasham Varunaha Shanno Bhavatvaryama Shanna Indro Bruhaspatihi Shanno Vishnururukramaha Namo Brahmane Namaste Vayo Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahma Vadishyami Rutam Vadishyami Satyam Vadishyami Tanmam Avatu Tadvaktaram Avatu Avatu Mam Avatu Vaktaram Om Shanti 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 Shruti Smriti Puranana Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Padam Shankaram Loka Shankaram Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadhyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Parthaya Pratibodhita Bhagavata Narayane Nasvayam Vyasena Kratitam Purana Munina Madhye Mahabharatam Advaitam Rutavarshinim Bhagavati Ashtadashadhyayini Ambatvam Anusandhami Bhagavad Gita Bhavatveshini From 16th verse, Nasato Vidyate Bhavah Nahavo Vidyate Satah Ubhayorapi Drushtontah Vanayos Tattva Darshi Vihi Avinashitu Tadvidhi. See, after Avinashi, don't stop. Avinashitu Tadvidhi Yena Sarvamidam Tatam Vinasham avyayasyasya Nakashchit kartum arhati Antavanta ime dehaha Nityasyokta sharirinah Anashino Prameyasya Tasmad Yudhyasva Bharata So Bhagavan said that Arjuna, there is no being for Asat and there is no non-being of Sat. And wise man know this very well. that asat is asat and sat is sat. Sat is always there and asat is never there, even though it appears to be there. May you know this. Plus, then he went on to elaborate upon sat. He said, avinashitu tad viddi yena sar. Even whenever we are transacting, whenever we are with the world, and world is always there. So he says, yena sarvam idam tatam, that by which all this is pervaded. Everywhere what you see is world, but that by which the world is pervaded is avinashi, is indestructible. In the world right before you, you will see that things are being destroyed, but that by which all this is there is not destroyed, avinashi. Know it to be, know that vinasham avyayasya asya, asya avyayasya vinasham, asya avyayasya. Asya avyayasya means for this which is partless, for this which is partless, na kaschit vinasham kartum arhati. Nobody can ever bring about its destruction. Nobody means who? Even Ishvara. Nobody else is capable. But Ishvara is capable, no? For bringing about destruction of anything. In a second he can just destroy. Things will be no more there. Even he cannot. Na kaschit kartum means Ishvara api. Bhashyakara beautifully wrote, na kaschit atmanam vinashayitum shaknoti Ishvarah api. Ishvarah api cannot bring about destruction of atma. Why? Because atma is atma of Ishvara also. Ishvara is Ishvara because of atma. Ishvara has the satta and spurti to be Ishvara is also because of atma. Atma means isness. Ishvara is. Just as sun gataha, pot is, sun pataha, cloth is, similarly Ishvara is. Isness is the main thing. Isness means existence. So, based upon this existence is the very adhishthanam for everything. Then, okay, Bhagavan, you said that sat can never be destroyed. Then what is that which is being destroyed? Then in the verse 17th, Bhagavan explained how there is no vyabhichara for sat. Remember this. There is no vyabhichara, negation for sat, that he explained. Then we should also know what is that asat for which there is vyabhichara. Vyabhichara means destruction, negation. That also, see, we should know both, huh? We should know how sat doesn't go and how asat goes. Both we should know. Kim punaha tat asat yat svatma sattam vyabhicharati. What is that asat which gives way to its own being? What is that? Tell us that also. Because see, for viveka of atma and anatta, anatma, viveka for sat and asat, we should know both. Whenever you want to do viveka, if I tell you that separate rice and wheat are together, and if I tell you separate them, then you should know what is called wheat and what is called rice. So here also now viveka is going on of atma and anatma. So we should be very clear about what is asat and what is sat, what is atma and what is anatma. So now he is showing us that how anatma is non-stable, how anatma is constantly going. Means it is mithya. For asat, the word that is used here is mithya. So he said, antavanta ime dehaha. Then yesterday we were discussing that for nityasya sharirinaha, very important. Sharirinaha means the one who abides in the body. And how is this shariri? Nityasya. Nityasya sharirinaha. For the one who lives, one who indwells in, for one who has the body. Sharirinaha. One who lives in the body, But how is that indweller? Then nityasya. For the nityasya sharira, here a singular is used. Nityasya sharirinaham ime dehaha. All these bodies are antavantaha. They are all antavanta, subject to being destroyed. Subject to being destroyed. Then in the second line, Bhagavan further explained the nityasya sharirinaha. More explanation is given about the shariri, one who lives in the body. How is that? In the earlier line he said nityasya, but still in the second line he is using one more word. Which word? Anashinaha. He is also anah. Now what is the difference between anashi and nitya? Then Bhashyakara will give. So two more words are used for atma or sharirinaha in the second line. Anashinaha plus aprameyasya. It is for the aprameya, for the anashinaha, for the nityasya, there is no destruction. So you fight. Tasmat yudhyasva bharata. Therefore, O Bharata, you fight. So now we were doing this, we were discussing this. So let us see what is the meaning of antavantaha. This, all these bodies are antavantaha. Antavanta means antaha vinashaha vidyate yesham, for those which have vinasha. But vinasha of what kind? Yatha mrugatrushnika, remember, yatha mrugatrushnikadau sadbuddhihi anuvruttaha pramana nirupanante vichidyate satasyaha anta. He says, just as for the marichi mrugatrushnika, for a marichi udaka, for the mirage water, what kind of reality is there for the mirage water? It has reality only as long as you do not inquire further. Only as long as you do not inquire further, till then mirage water is reality. Moment you inquire further, moment you go closer and see, then the reality of mrugatrushnika vanishes. What kind of reality does a snake have? Only as long as you don't go and see the rope. Moment you see the rope with your eyes, or if somebody else shows you with the help of the torch, then the reality of the snake is antavantaha. See, antavantaha. But the difference between snake and mrugatrushnika is, there is a difference between these two examples. What is that? What kind of reality snake is? Snake is also mithya. But moment you see rope, snake is not to be seen at all. Whereas in case of mirage water, even when you know that it is sand and not mirage water, means there is no water, there is only sand, but still it continues to be seen. You continue to see it. You follow what I am saying? Even when you see that there is no mirage, now you know. Now we don't, when we are going in a car, you know, then we see on the road itself, we see that there is water. But you know that there is no water. You safely drive. You continue to drive. Why? Because you know that this is only reflection of the sun falling on the road. So even when you know, it continues to be seen. Similarly, even when you know the reality of the world, still it is perceived. So perception is there. But now drashti is another. Drashti, that is what he is saying. Okay, how long this body, etc., what kind of reality does body have? Antavantaha. Just like mirage water. When you know the truth, you know the sat is truth in this, and this body falls in the category of asat. It is temporary, and even when it is there, it is constantly changing. This is what antavantaha means. Swapna maya dehadivat. Another example is given. How is this? Swapna maya dehadivat. Like the body seen in bodies and the whole world seen in the dream. When you wake up, you know that it was all false. And sometimes, you know, some people wake up even when the dream is going on. Little bit, you know, when you are about to wake up and still the some memory and something is there about the dream. So you are half woken and half asleep. You make out that this is dream, a little bit, but still dream goes on. And you are sort of half woken up. So now you know that this is false. But still it continues to, even if that is not real for all, take it to be real just now. Or Maya Deha Divat. Some yogis, some Siddha Purus are capable of creating things, even if they are not there. They just create with the help of their Shakti. So many things like, you know, there are so many Siddha Purushas who create. Like some Rishi only gave that apple to Danduli. Danduli, you know, he or whatever that name. Give it to your wife. And from that time, Dunduli. Dunduli. From that, the child was created. They are able to do all this. Siddha Purusha says, so what kind of this is? He says, Maya Dehadi, but all this falls in the category of Maya. But what are all this? Who? This body belongs to whom? Nityasya Sharira Vataha. And he is Anashinaha. Why did you use the another word? There was already one word in the first line, Nityasya. Why Anashinaha is used? To remove both the kinds of Nasha. Two kinds of Nashas are there. One is literal Nasha and another is relative Nasha. First we will talk of relative Nasha, as I told you yesterday. Yatha Deho, no. Vidyamanaha api anyatha parinataha vyadhyadi yuktaha jato nashtaha uchyate. What happens, as I told you yesterday, when somebody comes to know that they are suffering from some very terrible disease, terminal disease, the moment you hear about it, you are gone. Not only you, your family members also. They have nothing. They are all fine. But the moment they hear about your disease, they are also half gone. So what is this? This is also one kind of nasha. Does Atma have this kind of nasha? No. This kind of nasha is also not there. Then absolute nasha. Absolute nasha is yata deho basmi bhutah. When the body is totally burnt and cremated, there is no trace of the 6 feet, 7 feet tall man, 80 kilos or 120 kilos. He was weighing 120 kilo. And now there is nothing. Yatha deho basmi bhuta adarshanam gatah. It is totally vanished. This fellow is totally, why fellow? Elephants also vanish. So, this kind of absolute nasha also does not belong for Atma. You lost your money, that time also you die. People just die. Die means they are totally gone. So this kind of nasha, relative or absolute, both, to rule out both this kind of nasha, two words are used, nitya and anashina. Plus, otherwise why it was necessary to use both these words. Otherwise, here Bhashyakara says, anyatha prithivyadivat api nityatvam syat. Otherwise, what will happen? Prithvi also is relatively nitya. We all come and go. Kings come and go. But Prithvi remains as it is. So Atma, is Atma like Prithvi? Is Atma like planets? We also are there. So says even that kind of nityatvam, that is Prithvi is kutastha nityatvam. Kutastha nityatvam means it is there for a long, long time. Atma is not, when the pralaya will happen, this Prithvi will also go. When the total dissolution is there, Prithvi will also go. So Atma is not going to go in pralaya. Pralaya will happen because of Atma. So to rule out any kind of destruction, these words are used. Now comes another important word, aprameya. Atma is nitya, Atma is anashinaha, and Atma is aprameya. What is this aprameya? Aprameya again has come from the root ma. Ma means to measure. We have already seen in which word? Matra, sparshastu. There also the matra word was derived from the root ma, to measure. Here also aprameya, the word has come from ma, prameya. words are joined to it, visarga, things are joined to it, and then this word is formed. But the main root is ma. Ma means to measure. What is this prameya? First the word is prameya, and from the negation of it is aprameya. Huh? Prameya means that which you can see. Pratyakshadi pramanehi parichedya, which you can measure with the means of perceptions. Just as this thing is there, I measure it with my eyes. That is called pratyakshadi pramanehi parichedya. Parichedya means to limit it, to measure it. I measure it with my eyes. I measure this sound with my ears. So that is called prameya. If there is a flower, then I measure the smell of the flower with my granendriya. Is Atma measured like this? Is Atma seen like this? Then he says, no, Atma is aprameya. See, there are five kinds of pramana. Just pratyaksha, anumana, agama, upamana, and arthapatti. They are this. Pratyaksha, anumana, upamana, agama, and arthapatti. Just for your information, I am saying these five pramanas are there. And one of the pramana is shabda. Shabda means which pramana? Vedas. Vedas are also pramana. When you are using the word aprameya and you say that Atma cannot be known, aprameya means it cannot be known, it cannot be seen, then what are these Vedas doing? What are Vedas doing? You go to a teacher, do his seva, study with him, do seva for so many years, and then at the end of it, Guru says, Atma cannot be known. Atma is unknowable. So then what to do? Then what did you, why did you make me do all this seva? And now you are saying that Atma cannot be known. You should have told me this earlier. No, it is not like that. Aprameya means even though, so what are words doing with Atma, that we should know. Even though Atma is aprameya, then what is the work, what is the function of Vedas? Vedas have words, and are not words trying to show you Atma? Are not words revealing Atma? No. Prashyakara says, so prashna is, nanu agamena Atma parichyadyate. Prashna, Purva Paksha is asking, Atma, agamas, Vedas, they teach Atma. They try to limit Atma by words, means they reveal Atma by words. How can you say that Atma is aprameya? This word is not correct. So Bhashyakara says no. What it means is even Shabda or even Vedas cannot reveal Atma. Vedas cannot say that this is Atma. Showing means when I say this is, look upon this as spot. Supposing this is spot. If I say, when I say this is pot, you see this pot. Pot thought comes in your mind, and then that thought reveals this pot. When I say this is clip, clip thought occurs in your mind, and you see this clip. Does in the same manner, Atma or the words of the Shruti, do they reveal Atma? Nirgun Nirakar Atma, I say. Do you see that? No. So what is, then what are the words, what is Veda doing? Pashikara says that if Vedas were revealing Atma, then what will happen, you know? Atma will become anitya. Because the rule is what you see is anitya. And it is a fact. Yat drushyam tad anityam tad mithya. Whatever is seen is anitya. It is a rule. Whatever, not rule because it is a fact. Whatever you see is yad rupam, tad drishyam, tad anityam, tad mithya. Why? Because you have seen it. And we saw that everything, all names and forms fall in the category of asat. And what is this asat? Constantly changing. Today you see it this way, then you see it that. And then if Atma was seen, you are the seer, you are different from what is seen. You see Atma, and you are the seer, and Atma becomes seen. Already there is difference between the seer and the seen. Seer measures the seen and it is different. So then there will be two. So that way also Atma cannot be an object of your perception. If it is an object of your perception, it will be different from you. Plus whatever you see is constantly changing. Then it falls within the measure of all your perception. That way also Atma cannot be Nitya. Then what are words doing? Words can show you only that which is Nityam or Anitya. Then what are words doing? Bhashyakara says, yes, words do reveal Atma, but in what manner? Atma is already there before the Vedas. Atma, before you start seeing perception, before you start perceiving, Atma has to be there. You see, here he says, na, nahi Atma, Atma nama kasyachit aprasiddho bhavati. See, if Atma was not there, before you start seeing something, if Atma was not there, then what will happen? Atma came because of the Vedas. When you start studying the Vedas, before you started studying the Vedas, was Atma not there? Before you came to class, was Atma not there? If Vedas reveal Atma, understand, then what will happen? That I was not there before I came to this class. So it is not like that. Atma is always there. Then what is the function of the Vedas? They merely remove the wrong notions about the Atma which is already there. It is there but wrongly known. The function of the Vedas or the Shabda or the Shruti is merely to remove false notions entertained about Atma. See, here he says, Bhashyakara says, Shastram tu antyam pramana. Shastra is pramana for Atma. But in which manner? Atad dharma adhyaropana matra nivartakatvena pramana. By removing the notions. See, we all are there, but we have a false identity about ourselves. Atma, in spite of being Sachidananda, is looked upon as Jivatma, is looked upon as limited being. I am Nirgun, Nirakar, Sachid Anand. But what notions do I entertain about myself? I am this body, mind, intellect, complex. I am this small body. This is what I entertain. This is what I think about myself. So what does Shruti say? No, you are not this. You are not this. You are not this. So what is this? Atat dharma adhyaropa nivartakatvam. You are not. The function of the Shruti is merely to remove notions one by one. Then when the notions are removed, Atma is self-existent. Atma is self-evident. Even now, you are there. Atma is there. But what do I take myself to be? I am Paraprajnananda. I am Sannyasi. I am a woman. Then, in that, what is right and what is wrong? What is Sat and what is Asat? I is Sat, woman is Asat. You follow? When you say, I am so and so, I am Ramesh Bhai. Supposing, I am Ramesh. Somebody says, I am Ramesh. In this sentence, what is Sat and what is Asat? Ramesh is Asat and I is right. I is not body. I is not mind. I is not this. What is I? Sat. Consciousness. Even if there is an ant or a dog, even there, the dog part is false. What is right is I. So it is not that I need not exist. It always existed. But Shruti merely shows the real side of the real aspect of this I. the real nature of the I is revealed by Shruti. Shruti does not make you perceive that I. When the Shruti reveals that, you do not begin to see Atma. That yes, yes, now this, it is like, it is having this form. No, that never happens. But now the correct understanding of that I is there. What is that correct understanding? What is that correct understanding? That it is. It is. It is such an is which is not conditioned by any attribute. Huh? You follow what I am saying? It is such an existence which is not conditioned by any gunas, by any attribute. Just as when we say clay, pot, then the truth is clay and not pot. When you say mrut ghataha, so same sentence. When you say table, then chair, all these furnitures which are made of wood. In all those furnitures, what is truth is wood and not the form which the wood has taken. Similarly, here also, what is truth is. And the notions about them are only removed by Shruti. So, Atma remains aprameya. And therefore, yasmat evam nityaha avikriyaha, and that because Atma is avikriya, you fight. Because what Bhagavan is saying, see, this two, to connect this two is, we should understand. Bhagavan is saying Atma is nitya, anashi, aprameya, and the bodies are all dying, bodies are antavanta, therefore you fight. What does this mean? Therefore you fight means, what Bhagavan means is, do not think that there is destruction for Atma. And because there is no destruction for Atma, and you wanted to withdraw from the battlefield, thinking that everybody will die. You wanted to withdraw from the battlefield thinking that everybody will die and I will be their killer. Now that notion I have removed. That bodies will die definitely. But who will not die? Atma in all these bodies. Atma in such a big army, both the sides, will not die. Bodies of all these people will die. But who nityasya ashariranaha ime dehaha? What are the dehas? Antavantaha, in all this army, all the bodies of all, the whole army are antavanta. But the one who is there in them, one, he is not, Atma is not going to die. Therefore you fight. Now you start fighting. So what it means is, there are so many allegations upon Lord Krishna. Are you trying to command? Are you giving instruction to Arjuna to fight? Is Gita Shastra Pravritti Shastra? There are so many allegations upon Lord Krishna that it is he who made Arjuna did not want to fight and he who made Arjuna fight for his own reasons, for his own vested interest, Bhagavan made him do that. What interest does Bhagavan have, whether he fights or not fight, doesn't fight? Bhagavana says, whether you kill them, in 11th chapter, Lord Krishna, Bhagavana said to Arjuna, whether you kill them or not, they are already killed. What are you going to do? Those who have already fallen, you have to just push them. You have to just push the thing which is already about to fall. You know, it is about to fall. The tree has already been cut and you just touch it and it will fall. Similarly, all these people have already died. Kalaha. Kalosmi lokakshayakrut prabhu. I have become Kala. The Kala, I who is Kala, is already active. So they are already dead. What then? Why are you using me? I am giving you pain. You are Nimitta in my hands. I am giving you Yasha. If you want to take it, otherwise go. I don't need you. So this allegation is wrong about Bhagavana that he made Arjuna fight. And it is actually Arjuna had come to fight. It is not that Bhagavan invited him, please come and now start fighting. It was not like that. Arjuna had already decided to fight. So, nahi atra yuddha kartavyata vidiyate. Understand? Bhagavan is not giving yuddha kartavyata. You should fight, not like that. Merely, Arjuna had decided to quit from the battlefield because of his wrong notions, because of his wrong understanding. Bhagavan merely removed that wrong understanding. He merely removed. When that wrong understanding was removed, now Arjuna's understanding is clear and he has again now decided to, he will again now decide to fight. But it is not that Bhagavana is making him do. It is merely restatement of what Arjuna was really wanted to do. So, because the main Gita Shastra is really Nivritti Shastra and not Pravritti Shastra. The purpose of Gita is to remove Shoka and Moha and not make you fight. Not make you indulge in, if whether you do pravritti or not, Bhagavana is not interested in that. What is Bhagavana interested in? May there be no sorrow in your life. May there be no sorrow, no wrong notions about Atma in your life. That is what Bhagavana is interested in. Okay, now what Bhagavana does is, he says, now he wants to show, all this Bhagavana gave long lecture about Atma being Nitya and Anashi and Aprameya. But what is the guarantee? What is Pramanam for all that you are saying, Bhagavan? What is Pramanam? From where are you saying all this is from your own pocket? All this is all your figment of imagination? So Bhagavan also has to validate. He has to find a sanction for this from Shruti. See the place of Shruti in our tradition. This is the place of Upanishads and Shastra in our tradition. Even Bhagavan has to show that I am not saying whatever I am saying has the base in Shruti. To show that, Bhagavan is saying two verses which have their direct base in Kathopanishad. So now we'll be going into the verse which are similar to the mantras found in Kathopanishad. Bhagavad Gita, the main basis of Bhagavad Gita, you know, is Kathopanishad and Ishavasi. Of course, all Upanishads are there. Sarvopanishado kavah. All the Upanishads are like cow, and Bhagavana has, like a Gopala, he has taken from all the Upanishads. But the main theme of Kathopanishad is also death. And Ishavasya talks about two lifestyles. Which lifestyle? Pravritti and Nivritti, right in the beginning. So, Bhagavan has taken from that. So now Bhagavan, yattu manyase yuddhe bhishmadayah maya hanyate. You think that all these people, Bhishma, Dayah, Bhishma, etc. will be killed by me. And aham eva tesham hanta, I will be killing them. This buddhi you have, no? That I will be killing them and they will be killed. Or I will get killed by them. This itself is wrong. That I will be the killer and they will be killed. This buddhi which you have itself is mrusha. Itself is wrong. The notion that I am doing something and somebody will become the victim or the object of my doing, this itself is a notion. To show this, Bhagavana is giving two verses. And let us discuss that. Ya enam veti hantaram. Yashchainam manyate hatam. Ubautau na vijanitah. Nayam hanti na hanyate. See, he says, and again, as I told you know, in the first, on the second day or third day, we said that this is Prathama Malla Nyaya. Prathama Malla Nyaya means the one who is the boxer and who wants to become the champion, need not go and fight with all the smaller people, smaller boxers. He just has to fight with the defending champion. Moment he knocks out the defending champion, he can say, I am the champion. I have become first. Similarly here, Bhagwan is taking the champion of all the reasons for sorrow. What is that? Death. Death is the biggest cause of fear, biggest cause of sorrow, biggest cause of grief. That itself is knocked out. Killing, and the worst kind of action is killing. There cannot be a higher unbecoming action. So here that killing itself is taken. That even this action, even when you perform this action, you are really not performing. Atma doesn't even do this kind of action. And even if it does, there is no papa. If you know that Atma is not doing. So that how Atma is free from karma. How Atma is free from kartrutva, that is being shown here. He says, ya enam vetti hantaram. Ya means he, who, she, whoever. Whoever, ya enam. Enam means to this Atma. One who thinks Atma, enam means, it is a pronoun. One who thinks Atma to be, vetti means one who knows Atma to be hantaram. Hantaram means killer. I am killer. I am doing the action of, performing the action of killing. One who thinks that I am the killer and the other fellow. Yascha enam, yaha cha enam, another one also thinks that manyate hatam, I am being killed. Supposing this hand is the killer and it is killing this hand. So this fellow thinks I am the killer. And this one thinks, oh my goodness, oh God, I am dying. So this one thinks I am killer and this one thinks I am killed. Both this, even this fellow and this fellow, the killer and the killed. Ubhautau na vijani, both of them do not know. What they do not know? They don't know something. Nayam hanti na hanyate. They don't know why, because nobody kills and nobody gets killed. Nayam hanti na ayam means Atma doesn't kill and Atma doesn't get killed. Doesn't kill and doesn't get killed. Atma is not subject, Atma is not even object. Atma is not subject of karma, that means it is not karta, and it is not object of karma means nothing happens to it. Doesn't do and doesn't, and Atma is something upon which nothing happens. How beautiful. Atma it's himself, Atma is not only he, it is she also. Atma doesn't do and also doesn't become the object of karma. So absolutely karma has no play upon Atma. How beautiful. Karma cannot do anything to Atma. Atma cannot itself perform karma. As well as nothing can happen upon Atma because of karma. Otherwise, see, this is this thing. This may not do anything, but it will become the object of doing. Karma here means object. Karma has two meanings. Karma means to do, and another meaning of karma is object of it. Something happens upon it. I mean, some people, I don't do anything, but people come and do. The world is too much upon me. The world is always harassing me. The world is always pushing me. Some people, you know, they always become they have such low self-esteem about themselves. So they feel that the world is always upon me. World is always harassing me. Atma doesn't become the object of harassment also. And Atma doesn't become aggressive. From both these notions, Atma is free. So one need not suffer from guilty complex also, that I did, I happened to do it. And one did not entertain the other notion also. Everybody did this to me. They had my whole life went like that. Always I was harassed by this fellow, and this thing, and that thing. This body may have been harassed, but not Atma. So, this is what? Very big thing is revealed about Atma, that it is completely free from karma. He says, then Bhashyakara says, that one who prakrutam dehinam, enam means prakrutam dehinam, for the one who lives in the body, one who thinks that I am the hanana kriya yaha kartara, I am the one who performs the action of killing. And the other one who thinks that I am hatam means hanana kriya yaha karma bhutam, I become the object, both of them na jnatavantaha, both of them are aviveki, follow. Both of them are aviveki. And therefore, why? Because na hanana kriya yaha karta bhavati, na cha karma bhavati, what is the reason? Avikriyatva. See, if Atma had parts, understand, if Atma had parts, then it would get up and use the hands and kill somebody. And if Atma had parts, then when the Shastra etc. is used, with the help of those Shastra, Atma will be killed. Parts will be separated. But Atma is Niravayava and Avikriya, shapeless, formless, nameless. There is absolutely nothing which you can touch upon. So, Atma is not even Karta as well as not Karma. So to think that I did this, I did that, I am a papi, I am a punyashali, I am a rich man, I have so many good qualities in me, that is also wrong. I have to do this, I have to do that, that means you are taking yourself to be Karta. When a person calls himself, I am a doer, then he doesn't know. You follow? To think oneself to be a doer, I brought up my children, I earned this money, I am cooking, I am driving, I am teaching, I am studying. All these actions are superimposed upon Atma. They are not there. Atma is not a doer. Then Bhagavan, you are talking. Then what about that? I am talking but not talking. I am talking and still not talking. Bhashyakara is writing but not writing. Vedavyasa is writing but not writing. Ganeshji is writing but not writing. Speaking but not speaking. This is the central idea of Bhagavad Gita. Central idea. Bhagavan will say, naiva kinchit karomi, I don't do anything, even don't open my eyes. Pashyan, these are all involuntary actions. Without our knowledge also they happen. But you are not doing that. Pashyan, shunvan, sprushan, jigran. Then who is doing? Prakriti is doing. You are not doing. So Arjun, don't be afraid. If an action like killing is not done by Atma, then what to talk about the small actions, walking and talking and this thing. So, remove the notions that I am a papi, I am a punyashali. Then I can do whatever I... This doesn't give license to do what you want. Huh? This doesn't mean now I know. So let me cheat this fellow. Nothing is going to happen. Let me cheat him. Let me kill these animals. Nothing will happen. If there is a desire to do for self, out of selfishness, then definitely you will be punished. But here is knowledge. See, knowledge is different. Knowledge about the self. The self is free from action. Why? Because there is nothing in the self which can do. Doing requires so many things. First of all, desire. First of all, limbs. First of all, parts. Karta, karma, vyavadanam. So many things are required for action to happen. Karma has to be different. Things, duality has to be there. There is no duality. So this is knowledge. Sarva karma sannyasa is not an action. Real sannyasa, vidvat sannyasa is also not an action. Huh? Remember that. You renounced everything. If you think that you have renounced, you are doing something. You don't know. Real renunciation is when you know that Atma has never done anything. When Atma has not done anything, what are you going to renounce? When Atma has not done anything, who are you to renounce? You follow what I am saying? So renunciation also becomes action. But that is a lifestyle. That is a lifestyle taken up to understand what? To understand that Atma is free from action. So there are two kinds of sannyasa. One is vividisha sannyasa, which is taken to know. Vividisha means desire to know Atma. With the desire to know Atma, a lifestyle is taken up. That is called vividisha sannyasa, where you decide, no, now Vedas only, Shastra itself gives you permission. Okay, go, beta, and sit and think. But that action is done. Whereas vidvat sannyasa is, in spite of body working, you still know that Atma is free from any kind of action. This is real sannyasa. Huh? This sannyasa, even sannyasi has to know. Sannyasi also has to become this kind of sannyasi. You follow what I am saying? So, here in short, then how come Atma is avikriya? Katham avikriya Atma iti dvitiyo mantra, another mantra is also quoted. Not quoted, but Bhagavan is saying this. Both the words have the central idea of Kathopanishad. And the mantra of the Kathopanishad is, hanta chen manyate hantum. See, just see. Hanta chen manyate hantum, hatash chen manyate hatam, ubhau tauna. Second line is ditto. Ditto taken. You don't have it in your book. Don't look. I am saying from Kathopanishad. Ubhau tauna vijanitaha, nayam hanti na hanti. Second line is same. See, smruti, shrutis cannot be taken literally. You have to change little bit. So Bhagavan is also following all the rules. He also has to follow the rules. First line he changed little bit. First line there is hanta chen manyate hantum, hatash chen manyate hatam. Here he said, ya enam vetti hantaram, yaschenam manyate hatam. The second line is ditto beta. Beta it is taken. Now the same idea is continued in the verse 20. Now this verse, 20th verse, is in which meter? Trishtub meter. So far we have seen the mantras in Anushtub Chanda. Earlier also 2-3 verse, Guru Nahatva Hi Mahanu Bhavan, Karpanya Dosho, then Nachaitad Vidmaha, all this, that time I forgot to tell you. All these verses, in between you will find the verses in Trishtub Chanda. Otherwise, what is the Chanda in Bhagavad Gita? Anushtub Chanda. Trishtub Chanda is different. Na jayate mriyate va kadachita. Nayam bhutva bhavita vanabhuyah. Ajo nitya shashvatoyam puranah. Na hanyate hanyamane sharire. Here, already it has been done, but very specifically, all the vikriyas are removed from Atma. Removed in the sense that Atma is free from all the six vikriyas. See, six vikriyas are asti, jayate, vardate, viparinamate, apakshiyate and vinashyate. These are the six vikriyas. Here specifically it has been shown that Atma is free from all the six. That is why this has been said. Not clearly, but it is said. See, na jayate, it is not born. Mriyate va kadachit, never it is born, never it dies. Na jayate, mriyate va kadachit. Na ayam bhutva. Then again same thing is repeated. Having come, bhutva means having come into existence, abhavita na bhuyaha. It having come into existence, it doesn't again become non-existent. Huh? So, same idea. Bhutva abhavita va na, va and na again shows, see va and na shows that not being there before, what is birth? What is birth? It was not there before and then came. So, asti, jayate. Janma means it was not there before and it came. Does it happen in Atma that it was not there before and it came? So Va says Na. Then what does the word Na shows? Having been there, death means it was there and it will not be later on. It is there now and it will not be later. Does it apply to Atma? Says Na. So Va and Na again shows that the absence of prior non-existence and posterior non-existence. Then what is it? Ajaha, unborn, nityaha, ever there. Shashvata and Purana means there is no apakshya, no vruddhi, and apakshya means decline in Atma. That we will see tomorrow. Ajaha, nityaha, shashvata, ever there. Puranaha means Purana doesn't mean it is old. No, not old. Purana means ever fresh. Na hanyate hanyamane sharire. Even when the body is destroyed, it is not destroyed. Big thing. See, it is easy to understand this in words is one thing. But to bring it in life, you have to bring it in life. Life in the sense, then even when you see that body is going old, body is affected by things, apakshya, vruddhi, all these things are happening, nothing happens to me. You put it in the body. What belongs to asat, put it there. Be very clear. Be very clear in assigning things. Whatever belongs to the anatma, put it there. And what belongs to atma, put it. Some people are very good in hisab, you know. That accountants, smallest things they will account for. Even if 5 paisa also, this is not mine, put it in that account, put it in this account. Similarly, viveka is, be clear, na hanyate hanyamane sharire. That doesn't mean nothing will happen to body. Things will happen. With time everything will happen. If it doesn't happen, thank God. But if it happens, you should know that this is not in I, this is in there. It is in the body, not me. That doesn't mean you will say, this is happening there. No, in language you don't speak like that. This is coming and this is going and this is eating. No, this is sleeping. You don't begin to speak like that. If you begin to speak like that, then there is a big confusion. People will also wonder what is happening. To create confusion, you know. You need not speak like that. Some atmas speak like that. Okay, that is okay. But then we wonder what is going on. So you need not speak like that. But this is now an enlightened ahankara. So far it was ignorant ahankara. Wise men are enlightened ahankaras, huh? Ahankara is there. But what kind of ahankara? Even wise men say, I have to teach, I have a class, I have to go to US. I will not be available for so many days. So you mean to say that you are acting? In Vyavahara, without some identification with body-mind complex, nothing can happen. So some identification is there, but truth is known. So they are called enlightened ahankara. There also some kartrutva is there. But what kind of kartrutva is there? Enlightened kartrutva. Enlightened. Enlightened means they know. Even though they are doing, they know that this is done by the body. You know, not every time speak. For speaking, some kind of identification is required. Some thinking is required. Otherwise, what can you speak? So you do, but still you know that Atma has not done. body has done, mind has done, mind thought, speech spoke, Atma's presence was there. Maya dyakshena prakriti hi suyate sacharacha. In my presence all this is happening. But every time you don't speak like this. Huh? So in short, in these two verses, all the vikriyas are removed from Atma. Removed in the sense, it has been shown that Atma is totally avikriya. Avikriya. Nothing happens. So don't worry, Arjuna. Do what is to be done. Don't be afraid. If you know this, no papa will come to you. If you do not know this, and you do it, then definitely there is some papa. But if you know this, then why will I do if I know this? Because it is your duty. As a human being, as a kshatriya, you are placed in this position, so do it. But in reality, be aware that Atma is not doing. That is what is it. Tomorrow we will do little bit of this mantra for just some clarification and then proceed with 21st verse. Okay? Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punaha Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.